The coroner confirms it was a Carlisle Honor Student's baby found buried behind a Warren County home. Now the question is whether the child was alive at birth or stillborn. That new information comes as Brooke Richardson had her first court appearance. Not on your sides. Tom McKee was there and has this new information from Franklin.
The hearing in Franklin Municipal Court was based on this complaint filed against Brooke Richardson. It says on or about May 7th in Franklin Township, she did cause the death of another or the unlawful termination of another's pregnancy. The remains of the child weren't discovered until weeks later.
Brooke Richardson, also known as Skylar, was flanked by her parents and surrounded by supporters Friday as she entered Franklin Municipal Court. She was there on a charge of reckless homicide filed Thursday night. Investigators dug up skeletal remains of a baby on July 14th, taking buckets full of material from a woods near a Carlisle home on Eagle Ridge Drive. They returned Thursday and concentrated on a fire pit behind a Carlisle house, taking away more potential evidence. That was to help pathologists determine if the child was alive at birth or stillborn. Richardson was arrested a short time later, but bonded out within a few hours. In court Friday, Judge Rupert Rupert set a preliminary hearing for August 1st and kept bond at $15,000.
There's no reason to believe that you'll violate the terms of your bond since you have an attorney with you and you're here in the courtroom.
It was over in a few minutes. There was no plea. Richardson said nothing. Her attorney, Charles Ritgers, says it's been traumatic on his client.
She's taking it in the way that you'd expect. It's a shock to her and it's a tragic situation.
Richardson graduated from Carlisle High School in the spring, where she was on the National Honor Society, a cheerleader, a member of the track team, and the homecoming court.
She has plans to start college very soon. She didn't drink. She wasn't a partier or a smoker. By all measures, a very good girl who helped actual children. Children with disabilities.
Rickers wouldn't comment on the specifics of the case, saying he was just retained Friday morning and hasn't had enough time to talk to Richardson, her family, or investigators. If convicted on the charge, Richardson could spend between 1 and 5 years in prison. Tom McKee, Night on Your Side, Franklin.